Loughborough has a long tradition of specialist industry, and evidence of the bell business is visible everywhere, from the impressive War Memorial Bell Carillon to the names of the streets. The Bell Foundry has been in the care of the Taylor family since the 18th century, moving to this site in 1859. This historic business is also the world's largest bell foundry, producing some of the UK's most famous examples. One of its directors is passionate bell ringer Simon Adams.
John Taylor Bell Foundry started in 1784. I've been here since the beginning of 2009. A lifelong interest in church bells is what brought me here. It's a hobby that's turned into a business. The process hasn't changed for hundreds of years how bells are made, and it's absolutely unique, the English method of casting bells. We've made large bells for Liverpool Cathedral, York Minster, Exeter Cathedral, Buckfast Abbey, St Paul's Cathedral, London.
Drew's targeted the foundry, hoping to pick up bespoke items relating to heavy industry. And over the last 150 years, plenty of discarded manufacturing pieces have piled up.
We've got old moulding tables, some electric light fittings, odd castings. Looking forward to showing Drew around to places where people don't normally get to go around here, and hopefully he can find something of interest to him that we would regard as hidden treasure.
Hello, Simon, how are you?
Morning, Drew.
How are you?
Morning, T. Good to see you.
Blimey. My God. Tell me about this.
Most of these are down for recasting for a project in Cheltenham. They've got a peal of 12 bells that aren't very tuneful, and the only way to improve them is to melt them down and recast them to a modern shape with good tuning so that they're improved in their quality of sound.
Incredible. I'm amazed. Aren't you?
It's stunning, yeah.
Unbelievable.
I'm just glad I don't have to carry them around.
Yeah. Literally, my face had hit the floor. I was like, I expected, like, you know, a little place. Look at it. Staggering.
Drew's targeted the foundry, hoping to pick up some authentic and historical pieces. And the most obvious and beautiful things here are the bells themselves.
So you've got some bells possibly for sale. These pair here,
they're a matching pair cast by ourselves. The reason they're here is because they were exchanged for more modern bells.
Okay.
They're literally as they were from 1874 when they left here, so they're completely unrestored and in their original as cast condition.
Which is exactly what I want. Unsurprisingly, today we're surrounded by loads of bells, and a lot of them are antique originals. People do like them, and mainly it's down to the history, the foundry, and the dates.
These 19th century bells from a church in North Yorkshire have been replaced by a more modern, harmonically tuned pair. Bells that take too much work to be mended are recast or sold on. These ones have the original maker's mark, giving them more value. When sold as a pair, they could be worth around £1,000.
650?
Still feels like too much, doesn't it? 600.
Okay, done.
Okay. When we come to places like this that are different, you're looking for the unique. And that's what getting into these places gives you the opportunity to do. And exactly what I wanted to happen has happened. We found here something exceptional. It's phenomenal.
Drew wants to go and have a look at some of the woodworking shops where the mechanisms in which the bells are hung are made.
This is the woodyard where we make all our timber fittings.
I'll tell you what I do want to look. I want to have a look at this. Tell me about this. Wow!
This is our wheel-making table.
I've got to ask, can I buy this?
Unfortunately not. It's part of our working kit.
That is fabulous.
We might have a bigger one somewhere that we don't use.
I want it.
Can I resign now before you buy the bigger one?
The factory definitely has the kind of items Drew was hoping to find. This bespoke wheel table isn't for sale, but it's certainly got him interested.
The wonderful thing about this table is that is made for doing that job. Nobody else will have one. This table is why we try and get into places like this, try and get into factories, old manufacturing units, because of that. Because you find stuff like this, which is just jaw-dropping. Incredible, the best of the best industrial furniture you're ever going to find.
Luckily, there's a second, even bigger tabletop discarded beneath a large storage area. It was in use, but isn't anymore, and has no base.
Oh my word.
If that's of interest to you.
What a thing.
That's making even bigger wheels than the ones you've seen today.
I really, 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 really want it. I have never bought one of those before.
If you put a base on that, that's the most awesome dining table, isn't it?
The most awesome dining table in the world.
We get all the knights round that.
We're stood in front of a piece of industrial history, a big one, that would, I think, make the best single garden or dining table in the world. What a find. It's got everything going for it. It doesn't get much better than that.
This bespoke 3-metre-wide 19th century table was made for the specific purpose of producing bell wheels, in which bells are suspended and then operated by ropes. A unique industrial piece, it bears almost 2 centuries of oil staining and wear. Unlike anything else on the market, once attached to a base and with the oil removed, this table could be worth around £2,500.
I would actually have to check to see if we can actually sell it or whether we're going to need it for anything.
What do you want for it?
700.
If you want to sell it, I'll buy it all day long.
OK, we'll consider it to be subject to approval.
Sold subject to contract.
A done deal.
If I can, I'm buying it. It's fabulous, but a hell of a lot of work. Really excited. I want it. I really want it.
Drew's going to have to wait to find out whether he can seal the deal on the large tabletop. In the meantime, he wants to see if he can find any other pieces of industrial salvage scattered around the enormous foundry.
So what have we got in here, then?
Paint shop where the clappers are done.
These lights.
Oh, yes, I've forgotten about those, yeah. There's a rather large one there.
Have you got any more of that one? One at the back there? Are they a pair? That's great. What colour's the outside? Grey. Was also available in grey.
Well, that's untouched.
These three lights are industrial discharge lights, meaning they're designed to give off an especially bright beam. They're very worn with age and use, but the bell shape of one and the others as a matching pair means they could be worth around £450.
In industrial lighting, a mainstay of my business over the years.
Give me a price for the lot.
Absolute end of it, no more 150 to 3, that's it, done.
I don't even feel like bartering on that. That'll do.
Thank you.
Thanks, mate.